Miss Pretty, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-C-Y-G-Y syzygy.
We have a winner!
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you!
At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, my parents keep on telling me that he cares winning, although I know it isn't so.
But it's a very nice, very, very nice, very, very nice, very nice beginning. Our winner here last year, Chip Tolentino.
From shaking.
Alack, his making will not pass.
Cause it's a very big, very fraught, simple, but it's not. It's a very big undertaking.
Returning after last season's tragic setback, William Barthy.
It's Barthy, it's an accent, a goo.
Oh, I'm not sure who this girl is.
Plasma TV and a fancy hotel where they treat you well. All because you love to spell. We spell.
It's a marvelous memory. If you win a spelling bee, once life improves from A to Z.
Excuse me. Can't you see I blocked this area off with invisible tape?
Oh, sorry.
At the 25th annual, we memorized the manual
about how to spell these words. Words that require thought. People think we're automatons, but that is exactly what we're not.
Concentrate
on winning. At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, we speak so damn convincingly.
They're nervous but pretty.
It seems we're living out our dreams,
which is a very nice, very nice, very, very, very nice,
very, very nice, nice, very nice, nice, very, 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 very nice beginning.
25th annual.
25th annual. Putnam County Spelling Bee.
no vote is at the B. Now our fire exit is located over there at the door, and we will have a 15-minute break later on in the B. And there are some names who haven't signed in yet, so if I call your name, please come up onto the stage and to the table. I have a Mr. Micah Kelly, a Mrs. Jeanette Acock, a Mr. Mike Gordon, and a Mr. Alex Webster. Oh, and I need to speak to a Miss Olive Ostrovsky, please.
I'm Olive.
Hi, dear. It seems we haven't received your entrance fee yet.
Entrance fee?
Oh, did your school not tell you about the $25 entrance fee? Is perhaps your mom?
My dad
had
to go into work. He's going to come later.
Oh, who brought you to the B, dear?
The bus.
All right, we'll discuss the entrance fee later. Go on and take your seat.
Hey, Marcy, don't be nervous. Watch me.
Don't worry, I'm not.
Have you ever been in an underground gymnasium before?
I've never been in a gymnasium before!
What school do you go to?
Shut up!
Ladies and gentlemen, the children you see here on stage today are here because of their extraordinary ability and love of language. But only one of them can go on to compete in the National Spelling Bee. And today, to commemorate our silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrist, are offering today's winner, drumroll please, a $200 savings bond towards his or her future education. But remember, each child here had to win.
Oh, but I...
or place in their district B, so each of them is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Hello, I am Rona Lisa Pretty, and I am pleased to be back for my 9th consecutive year as your host. Now, unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Superintendent Timmy, cannot be here tonight because he forgot his wife's birthday. There's no telling how long he'll be in the hospital for, so please join me in welcoming back Vice Principal Douglas Panch from Dos Passos Junior High. Us after a 5-year hiatus, so thank you, Douglas, for stepping on such short notice.
Thank you, Rona, and may I just say, after that incident 5 years ago, I'm in a much better place now. It's amazing what a change of diet can do for a man. Thank you.
Wonderful.
And might I add, Miss Pretty here is not only one of Putnam County's top realtors, she's also a spelling champ herself.
Third annual!
Syzygy.
When the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
Beautiful. And now, the Pledge of Allegiance led by our comfort counselor, Miss Michelle M. Mahoney.
Miss Michelle Mahoney is doing her community service work with us today.
Just call me Mitch.
For which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, spellers. You may now be seated.
And now for the official spelling bee rules.
A speller.
A speller.
May ask questions. About the word pronunciation or definition.
Definition.
Is used in a sentence.
In a sentence.
And its language of origin.
Language of origin.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over.
But the sequence of words already spoken may not be changed.
If you misspell a word.
Misspell a word.
You ring the bell. And the comfort counselor.
Mitch Mahoney
will escort you off stage.
Is that understood, spellers?
Yes.
Before anyone is disqualified and before proceedings turn snide and contestants turn nasty, I soberly confide the moment before the beat claims first catastrophe. I love what I see. Can
strabismus.
Strabismus. May I have the definition of that word?
The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision with the other because of an imbalance of the muscles of the eyeball.
And can you use it in a sentence, please?
In the schoolyard, Billy protested that he wasn't cockeyed. I suffer from strabismus, he said. Whereupon, the bullies beat him harder.
Notice how she writes on her forearm. This is her way to see the word before she spells it out loud. Wonderful!
Strabismus. S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S. Strabismus.
That is correct. Mr. Coney Bear!
Mr. Coney Bear came in second runner-up in the Putnam Basin District Spelling Bee.
Lance, can you tell
Lady
he has a phone call?
Oh, thanks, I got it. Hello, Lee speaking. No way, I'm gonna represent the Basin and the Bee? I can't believe it! Mom, Dad, Marigold, Brooke, Pinecone, Raisin, Landscape, Jeanette, you're not gonna believe this! I made the county finals of the Spelling Bee!
Oh, but honey, you came in third.
Oh, I know. But they just called, so the person who came in first has to go to their bar mitzvah. And the person who came in second has to attend their bar mitzvah. So they want me to do it.
You do realize that everyone else will have won their bees?
Oh, I know. It's just, well...
Capybara!
What?
Your word is capybara.
Is that a word?
Yes, that's a word.
No way, what does it mean?
A tailless, largely aquatic South American rodent, often exceeding 4 feet in length.
Wow. Is there anything else I can ask?
You're allowed to ask for the word, the language of origin for the word, or to use the word in a sentence.
Oh, can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. Don't look now, Pedro, but I think that tailless, largely aquatic, 4.5-foot rodent swimming next to you may be a capybara.
Wow, that didn't help at all.
Are you ready to spell the word, Mr. Coney Bear?
No, but it was very fun to come here. Hi, guys, my whole family's here, which is really C-A-P-Y. B-A-R-A. Capybara.
That's correct.
It is? I can't believe it! I'm so excited to get my
name! Miss Ostrovsky!
Miss Ostrovsky placed second place in her school's Halloween contest.
I was roadkill.
Boanthropy!
Boanthropy? May I have the definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am, could you not sit in that seat? I saved a chair for my dad on the fourth row on the aisle. And it may take him a while, but when he gets here, that's his chair. Cause my mother's in an ashram in India. I saved a chair for her too. As daily she washes herself in the Ganges. And I live in a house where there's an oversized dictionary that I read as a girl on the toilet.
Boanthropy!
Is that from the Latin root bo meaning ox and the Greek root anthro meaning man?
Sure.
I love my dictionary and I love the indented border.
Into her hand and towards the side.
So I will not make a mistake and be discordant.
hypoanthropy?
That is correct.
Using a sentence?
Don't listen to the other boys, Richie. Richie Richards' mother said, we are not intolerant, we're racist.
Intolerant. I-N-T-O-L-A-R-A-N-T. Intolerant.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is I-N-T-O-L-E-R-A-N-T.
Luckily, this time was not a happy accident.
Goodbye. You were good, but not good enough. So please don't ask why. Simply say goodbye.
And I had such high hopes for him.
Don't give up painting.
Hello.
Mr. Barfy has a rare mucous membrane disorder.
Lugubrious.
Lugubrious, meaning extremely sad and goopy?
More or less, yes.
A topic I am all too familiar with. What about Lugubrious?
Alright, watch this technique. He calls it the magic foot, and he's the only one I've ever seen use it. He spells the word on the floor with his foot so he can get a visual, and then speaks it out loud. Incredible!
L-U-G-U, Lagoo. B-I-O-U-S, Lugubrious.
That is correct.
I know.
Mr. Micah Kelly!
Mr. Micah Kelly got lost in his own closet, probably because he doesn't have a room.
Poor child. The word is Mexican.
Mexican?
Only the speller at the microphone may spell the word.
But that's so easy.
I don't care. Mr. Kelly, your word is Mexican. A resident of Mexico, or an American slang term for anyone from Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, South America, or Spain.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Guacamole, the Mexican pudding.
M-E-X-I-C-A-N.
That is correct! Miss Park!
Miss Park placed first in the National Spelling Bee as a resident of Virginia.
First. Beautiful country.
Miss Park, the word is phylactery.
Phylactery. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
Thank you. May I have the definition, please?
Either of two small square leather boxes containing religious texts traditionally worn on the left arm and head by Jewish men during morning weekday prayers.
Thank you. May I have a sentence, please?
Billy, put down that phylactery. We're Baptist.
Thank you. Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y, phylactery.
That is correct. Mr. Tolentino!
Hey, mercy, Hayden. Hey, you remember me? I was in Nationals, too.
I only remember the top.
Charlito Chip Tolentino is a little league pitcher with a wicked 22-mile-an-hour screwball.
Omphaloskepsis!
Well, hold on. Did the other guy get Mexican?
Yes, and you got omphaloskepsis.
Is that the same level word?
They're both level one words, yes.
Omphaloskepsis. Can it be pronounced omphaloskepsis?
It can. You would be wrong!
Omphaloskepsis. O-N-P-H A-L-O S-K-E-P-S-I-S. Omphaloskepsis.
That is correct!
You represent skepsis! That's what it means to be a real champion.
Mr. Mike Gordon!
Mr. Mike Gordon, on his first trip to the barber shop, told the barber to give him the Dr. Phil.
You also have a daytime talk show. You should probably look into it. You could be like a miniature Dr. Phil. All right, Your word is cow.
Cow?
Only the speller at the microphone, please. Cow.
Cow?
Cow.
Can I see the definition?
It means cow.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Spell cow.
C-O-W.
That is correct. That is correct! Mr. Pony Bear!
Mr. Coney Bear makes his own clothes. Very stylish.
A coochie.
A what?
Listen to the whole word, please. A coochie.
At a spelling bee? What does it mean?
A South American rodent of the genus Myoprocta, resembling an agoutie.
It's funny how I keep getting South American rodents.
Hilarious.
Look, honestly, I've never heard this word before, and I have no idea how to spell it.
Why don't you give it your best shot, Mr. Coney Bear?
I'm not that smart. My siblings have been telling me that for years, that I'm not smart. We're schooled at home, they see who's bright, it breaks my heart. I'm not that smart. Guess what? You know what? Guess what? I have a gentle personality, which you'll all agree is an anathema out of my more aggressive family. Everyone keeps swatting. Everyone keeps yelling,
"Don't kid!"
How could a flea such as me think he'd be good at spelling?
How?
I don't know. I like my hair. Really, it is pleasant to the touch. I toss my hair a bit too much. It doesn't move, it simply sits. I make a part, I'm not that smart. Da 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 da
da da da da da da.
Word.
Oh my god, a coochie!
Oh yeah, a coochie. The rodent resembling the other rodent. What was it? A C O U C H I. A coochie. I might be smart. My siblings can't believe that I got it right. But I got it right, right? I didn't cheat. I saw this light and it was neat. I like to laugh, I like to spell, I like to never hear the bell. And if this competition's hell, at least I'm finally a part. I feel my heart begin to swell. I love to spell. I like it a lot.
Mother-in-law of Miss Michelle Mahoney. I think they might need to have a couple words after this.
Interesting. Are you gonna have a prison wedding? Yes, that's what I thought. Your word is foppish.
Can I have a definition, please?
Foppish. It means concerned with one's clothes and appearance in an affected and excessive way.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
The foppish woman spent 5 hours picking out the right dress for her date with a blind man.
Foppish. P-H-A-P-I-S-H.
That is correct.
Ostrovsky's mother is currently on a 9-month spiritual trip in India.
Flagellant.
Flagellant. That's a verb, right?
Yes.
May I have the definition?
I'm going to need you to ask you to speak clearly into the microphone.
Oh, sorry. It's all right, dear. Just turn and face us. You know what this girl needs? She needs to learn how to stand like a champion. All right. Shoulders back, chin up, hair away from your face. Very good. It's a hard age for girls.
I fell.
boys. With this difference, ask a child if they expect to win a spelling bee, and the boys and girls are trained to respond differently. For example, the boys are trained to respond,
"I'm taking it all, you're all going down!"
While the girls are trained to respond,
"Well, I don't know. I mean, I'm a good speller, but I'm not a truly great speller. And though I have trained really hard, there's so much luck involved."
Though in my experience, the girls are always thinking,
"I'm taking it all, y'all going down, fuckers!"
While the boys are always thinking,
I don't know. Am I good enough or not?
I'm thinking about this flagella at 1L or 2. And also, if you take the WF answer, the 18 ghosts, the extra A and aardvark, and the teen listen, you could keep saying what, but nobody would hear you because the entire word would be silent.
We still need you to speak up, dear.
Flagellant! F-L-A-G-E-L-L-A-T-E, flagellant!
Very good on the volume and correct.
That girl on the left side from the middle, you know, third out of third aisle, with four seats from, yeah, that one right there. Who's that?
That's my sister, Marigold.
Marigold.
Because I liked torturing her, Miss Jeanette Acock.
Miss Jeanette Acock has a birthmark shaped like North Korea. She says it's totally nuclear.
Too soon, Miss Acock. Too soon.
I do have six boys.
Your word is hoe-cake.
Hoe-cake. Can you give me the definition?
A coarse cake made of cornmeal, usually a southern dish.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
The speller was sweating like a hoe-cake baking in a church oven.
Hoe-cake. H-O-E-C-A-K-E.
That is correct! Mr. Mike Gordon!
Mr. Mike Gordon, when he spells, goes by the nickname Danny DeVito.
Are you not Danny DeVito? I loved you in Batman.
You were amazing in The Princess Bride.
Moving on. Fandango.
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 May I have a definition?
A lively Spanish dance for two people.
Can you use it in a sentence?
I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the Fandango?
F-A-N-D-A-N-G-O.
That is correct! Mr. Micah Kelly!
Harry Potter's lesser-known twin brother, Mr. Micah Kelly, got sent to Hufflepuff.
Your word is hedonophobia.
Can I have the definition?
The fear of pleasure.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Franklin was diagnosed with mild hedonophobia after saying he wanted to rock and roll half the night and party every other day.
Can I hear the word again?
Hedonophobia.
H-E-A-T-E-N-A-P-H-O-B-I-A.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is H-E-D-O-N-O-P-H-O-B-I-A. I'm sorry, Hufflepuffs don't win at this game.
Goodbye!
Eliminated due to health-related reasons.
Were there peanuts in the brownies? Because they said there were gonna be no peanuts in the brownies.
I'm glad to see him back at spelling so well.
Hossenpfeffer.
Hossenpfeffer. I only seasoned with rabbit stew, often served with sour cream.
Rabbit stew, that's correct.
My old friend. One moment, please.
He's going for the foot!
Magic foot, take me to the final round. Magic foot, I barely lifted off the ground. Magic foot, I do it without making a sound. Magic foot,
right?
Magic foot, right that stupid letter. Magic foot, it's an alphabet, a way to spell. Okay, let's see what we got here. H-A-S-E-N. Hossen. A B-F-E-F-F. Puffet. E. R. Let's go. A magic foot. Be specific. A magic foot. Ain't terrific if you're not specific. Magic foot. When I make a word with my foot, magic foot,
magic foot, magic foot, magic foot, magic foot,
magic foot, magic foot, don't go kaput, foot,
magic foot,
magic foot, magic, write the dadgum letter,
magic foot,
don't away, it's an alphabet, a way to spell.
Xanadu.
Y-A-N-D-O.
That's right, the correct spelling is X-A-N-A-D-U.
So, I do what I can.
I'm here to bring comfort. Give them a juice box, a hug if they want. I'm here to bring comfort. Let's go.
Miss Freddy, can I have another turn, please?
Let's go, kid.
Pronounce it one more time, please.
Okay.
Can you pronounce it again?
Cambodia.
C-A-B-A-U-T-I.
Morphobia.
R-U-P-H-O-B-I-A.
You know what? I just love you so much. That is correct. That is correct.
Anyone for chocolate chips? Anyone for anything that isn't dated? How could I have been eliminated? You wanna know how? You wanna know how? You wanna know why? My unfortunate distraction seems to have ruined all interaction. It's to my satisfaction that everything I once did perfectly. Last year's champ defeated because of Marigold Coney. Something and nothing between us. I don't blame my brain, but I do blame my penis. My unfortunate protuberance seems to have its own exuberance. Anyone for Eminem? No. Delicious and appropriate. Anyone for Chewy Goober? Expensive. Anyone for buying the shit that I'm selling? Because my sissy has ruined my spelling. Distraction! Distraction! My unfortunate distraction! Oh! It's ruining my life, it's ruining my world, it's ruining, ruining, ruining my life! My life! Adulthood brings its own peculiar rejections, which is why I'm selling this PDA. Confession. It will ruin your complexion. All because of my good fortune.
See you next year.
What are you, nuts? Ah, nuts! Three hours! Can someone please pick up the peanuts? You know I'm allergic to peanuts!
You know, Barf, I might have lost, but you're the biggest loser.
Oh yeah?
Well, that is a common misconception!
Open your mouth.
No! Open your mouth! Here! Here! This is a bullet-free zone!
Sorry about that. William, right? I'm Olive.
I know who you are. Look, I don't need pity from someone named after a vegetable.
It's a fruit.
Well, it's a disgusting fruit, and I can't keep them down. It's not awful for a name, though.
Did you know that if you switch the first two vowels in Olive, it becomes I love?
Did you know that if you switch the first two vowels in William, it becomes... William?
Yeah, but if you switch the next two, it becomes Will Aim.
Are these the types of things you think about?
Yeah.
Right. I'm more of a science guy myself.
Well, you're also a really great speller.
Yeah? Thanks. Olive. I love.
That's so stupid.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming back our final spellers. And
Mayor, for being so supportive of me in all of my endeavors. Thank you, Dad!
Yeah. Yes, that is correct. Miss Clark. Yes, that's correct. That is 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 correct. Correct, 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 correct. I'm sorry, that is incorrect.
It is?
The correct ending is ILLA chinchilla.
I heard about that to me is not an inviting sound. That little ding, to me it brings a plaintive air. I always thought that life was fair. I mean, I never felt a smidgen of despair. They say the bell can break your heart, but just not mine. Since I opine, I think I know I'm smart. Apple juice, please. Woo!
Says my hobbies are weird, but my real mom, Sheila, says the hobbies, what did they pay off? And also, I grew up to become incredibly handsome.
Antihistamine!
Look at the draw. A-N-T-I-H-I-S-T-A-M-I-N-E. Antihistamine, Mr. Panchy.
Dog Panch.
Will Boffay.
Touche. Miss Park!
Miss Park speaks 5 languages.
No, I don't.
Oh, don't you?
No.
Well, it also says here that you won your school's handwriting contest.
Does it say that I only sleep 3 hours a night and that I hide in a bathroom cabinet and that I'm not allowed to cry?
No, it doesn't say that. Are you okay?
Well, it should say that. Should say, I speak 6 languages. Every language easy, easy as a recipe for making jello. I speak 6 languages, and I can say hello in at least 7 more.
Well, it also says you're a champion archer.
You're a salad, athletics, a song, typical flawed as a temperament. Apparently, I have the temperament.
Flow.
Are there any alternate definitions?
Yes. A channel to drain or carry off surplus water.
Are there any alternate definitions?
Yes. It's a body of water picked up behind a floodgate.
Are there any alternate definitions?
Why don't you quit stalling and spell the damn word?
Principal Panch.
Vice Principal Panch. Vice Principal, they won't even let me be principal.
That is correct, Yoko. What is wrong with you? Hey, not the kids!
For that incident. In my defense, I am lactose intolerant.
Miss Peretti, what did my dad say?
He said he'll be here in a little bit and he'll discuss the $25 entrance fee when he gets here.
Yeah, but what time did he say he was gonna be here?
It all started in 1998.
Okay. Yeah?
I was a late baby. I think my mommy wanted me.
And how does that make you feel?
Unwanted.
And we don't like feeling unwanted.
No.
No. It's okay. We're gonna get through this.
Thank you.
Well, we're gonna sit back down, okay? We're gonna get back to spelling, okay?
Okay, spelling.
And if you're good, we can get cannolis after, okay?
Is Danny DeVito still here?
Danny DeVito? I see him.
He's still here.
He's here.
I got your signature, Danny DeVito.
I got it right here. I'm gonna get it tattooed out.
We love you.
We do.
Okay. Then, back to the spelling. Miss Ostrovsky. chimerical.
What was the word?
Chimerical.
May I have the definition?
It means unreal, imaginary, visionary. Wildly fanciful, highly unrealistic.
I wish you were home.
Oh, if we couldn't be.
C-A-L. Highly unrealistic, wildly fanciful.
That is correct.
C-U-L-E, crepuscule.
That is correct!
Mom, I did it with a foot!
Miss Schwarzenegger!
Carl, Dad, I would just like to say that I can do this on my own.
Bug.
Bug? That's it? That's the whole word, bug?
Bug.
Language of origin.
Cornish dialect, a Latin derivative.
Cornish, that's like English with Dutch influence. Okay. Bug. B-U-G-G-H-E, bug.
I'm sorry, the correct answer is B-U-G, bug.
So simple?
So simple.
I'm so sorry, Dad. I'm overcomplicated. I hope you still love me, America, America. I gave it my best try. If you still don't love me, America.
forward. Now the rules state that we continue spelling until someone misses a word. At that point, the final speller must spell the next word correctly in order to win the bee.
Will come in H.
more candy with a lot more people.
Marcy continued to explore the freedom of not living up to expectations. She later wrote a book called Not Living Up to Expectations. It did not live up to expectations. She's very, very happy.
Leave Cody Bear. God, cats!
Studying for nationals with his new friend, Oliver Strofsky. He came in 42nd. He later grew to become incredibly handsome and gained fame and notoriety for his pioneering efforts in the combined studies of psychiatry and podiatry, otherwise known as psychiatry.
She grew up to be a loving and attentive parent and the host of her own radio talk show, where every year she'd interview the runner-up of the Putnam County Spelling Bee.
The 25th annual